Just like there are many kinds of quantum systems, there are also many ways to entangle quantum systems in the lab. But the basic concept is this: make it so that the measurements of two quantum systems are related to one another, like left and right shoes. But how does it happen?
Well, entanglement can be generated with all sorts of particles and with many different properties. You may have heard light described as a wave before. But at the quantum scale, we can even think of light as individual particles called photons. These photons themselves have a quantized property that we call polarization, very similar to how an electron has the quantized property of spin. Polarized light is used in a lot of quantum communication because photons are easier to send over long distances than other particles like electrons. After all, I can buy a cheap laser pointer from the dollar store to send photons all the way across the room, but doing the same thing with electrons would be much more challenging and expensive.
The simplest way to entangle quantum systems is to let them directly interact. If we bring atoms close together, for example, their energy states can become dependent on each other. But we can also do this with particles at a distance. Say we have two independent, unentangled atoms with electrons in identical excited states. Both electrons could drop down to a lower energy state in one of two ways. Each way emits a photon with a different polarization. If the atoms happen to emit two photons that have opposite polarizations, and we mix up the photons so that we don't know which came from which atom, then the photons will become entangled, which forces the atoms they come from to become entangled too.
Another way to entangle particles is to make them entangled when we create them. In some cases, the energy levels of an atom are such that it emits two photons when its electrons drop down into a lower energy state. And the polarizations of these photons either have the same polarization or opposite. Until one of these photons is measured, both photons are in a superposition of the possible polarization states, but the state of each is dependent on the state of the other.
Entanglement is also how quantum computers work. Quantum computers perform computations based on how their qubits are entangled with one another. It's not necessary that all a quantum computer's qubits are entangled at once. Instead, turning entanglement between individual groups of qubits on and off is how we perform different computations.